Yo, what is up everyone, Z-Karma here, and welcome back to another Borderlands 3 video. Today is the day. Bloody Harvest event is back with a bunch of new changes have arrived. There are weapon buffs, terror anointment changes, and most importantly, some insane Zane changes. I'm so happy about these changes on Zane, which I'll be talking about in this video. So let's not waste any more time and get through all the changes. So first off, the Bloody Harvest event has arrived. It will be active starting today until November 5th at 9 a.m. Pacific time. I'll be making a separate video talking about the event itself, so let's move on. They also brought changes to the Bloody Harvest weapons and anointments. First off, the Fearmonger. They increased the number of bullets shot per terror level, and they also increased the weapon damage. The Stalker Sniper Rifle received an increase to the weapon damage. The Gas Call Grenade also received an increase in damage. And now moving on to the Terror Anointments, the one that says while terrified, gain increased damage and fire rate. The more terror you have, the higher the bonus. They increase that damage bonus. We also have the while terrified, deal 50% bonus cryo damage. They have increased that 50% to 75%. We also have while terrified, enemy bullets have a chance to reflect off of you. The more terror you have, the higher the bonus, and that received an increase in damage. Moving on action skill end, apply terror to yourself every 5 seconds for the next 18 seconds. They adjusted the text to match what is happening in game. Moving on to the Siren anointment, after phase grasping an enemy, Amara fires terror skulls at the targets, dealing 3718 damage, and they also increase that damage bonus. Moving on to the Beastmaster anointment. After using attack command, consume all terror and flax pet gain increased of 50% bonus fire damage for a short time. So they increase that bonus fire damage. Moving on to the Gunner anointment, after reloading, consume all terror and create a Nova that deals cryo damage. They increase that damage from the Nova. We also have other general weapon buffs. Doll burst weapons now have increased fire rate, but this will not affect legendary weapons, so this is kind of confusing. Such a weird change. Anyway, moving on to the Laser Sploder, they have increased the damage scaling and magazine size. The conference call extra projectiles will now hit the initial target. This is an awesome change. The conference call, I guarantee you, will now be one of the best shotguns in the game. The Maggie received a slight increase in weapon damage. The Cycle Stabber has increased melee damage now, which is really nice because now it makes it a way better option than any other weapon that gives you melee bonus. Moving on, the Masterwork Crossbow has also received an increase in damage. And now for the best changes of this hotfix. There have been some insane changes for Zane. These changes are to add more build diversity and make other class mods more useful on Zane. Starting off with a skill called Cold Boar, this skill provides bonus cryo damage on the first shot after swapping weapons. This doesn't happen very often, so they increased the bonus cryo damage that you actually receive. Duct Tape mod, they reduce the cooldown by half. Moving on, Like a Ghost, they increase the chance to ignore a bullet and also increase the bonus for each active action skill. Trick of the Light, they increase the damage bonus to make up for the unpredictable damage. Best Served Cold has now received an increase in damage, and it'll be very interesting to see if this is now viable. And Futility Belt, this has increased the damage reduction, so we'll see about this one. Zane has also received changes to his class mods. For the Antifreeze class mod, the movement speed while taking cryo damage has been increased. The Conductor has now received an increase to the damage bonus. For the Executor class mod, the stat bonuses have been increased as they were not very impactful. And finally, the Techspert class mod. They increase the chance of a recharge to Sentinel's cooldown and active duration. 5% was apparently not enough, so that was further increased. And that has been it for the hotfix changes. Let me know what you all think about this. Personally, I'm very happy with all these changes, and I cannot wait to jump in the game and try them out. Hope you all enjoyed this video. Hope you have a good rest of your day, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace out.